CRS, what is this exactly? Chemical reaction symbol? Christian radio station?
Hallelujah!
Chinese rice silo? No, not exactly. CRS is the common reporting standard. Doesn't ring a bell? No problem, we're glad to explain it to you. Maybe you've already heard about FATCA. That's a US-American tax law that was first implemented in several countries, including Germany, Italy, and the UK in 2014. This law required that participating foreign banks, such as banks in Germany, report their US-American customers to their national tax office, who then send this information on to the IRS, the American Tax Authority. In this way, the USA are taking full advantage of collecting taxes from US citizens living abroad. Many other countries thought, that's actually not a bad idea. It's a tricky thing that with tax dodgers. Sometimes people prefer opening accounts in foreign countries, holding millions there, and their native country is left empty-handed. However, citizens living abroad often simply don't know that they are liable to pay taxes in their native country and become tax evaders inadvertently. To avoid all that, numerous countries implemented CRS nationally, a common standard for banks which was developed by the OECD and which regulates what data has to be collected from customers and where to forward it to. In this way, there will be more tax transparency worldwide. There are already 80 countries participating and counting. And this is how CRS works. The financial institutions of all participating countries, like the HypoVereinsbank in Germany, have to classify their customers as verified and not verified. Verified are those customers who have a tax residency in another CRS partner country. Then the HypoVereinsbank sends selected information like name, date of birth, tax residency and tax identification number, account balances and yields of those verified customers to the German Federal Tax Office in compliance with the standards set forth in German data protection laws. This central federal office collects the information from every bank, pools it, and sends this on to the respective foreign tax authority in accordance with the tax residency given by the customer. In this way, participating countries can be sure to receive information about foreign accounts of their citizens, thereby helping ensure that the correct tax is paid. This means a lot of work for the banks. It's a good thing that the HypoVereinsbank is already proficient in realizing the FATCA law for a few years. Under CRS, the customers are only additionally asked for their tax residences and tax identification numbers, so there are not too many changes, just the amount of verified customers rises. Besides that, the HypoVereinsbank, being a global player, is glad to contribute to the international promotion of tax transparency and to combat the worldwide problem of tax evasion.